Bueno, muy buenos días a todos, muchas gracias por su asistencia, por su interés. Les recuerdo, estamos en el ciclo de conferencias del Centro de Estudios China-México de la Facultad de Economía de la UNAM, que organizamos conjuntamente con la doctora Yolanda Trapa, ¿no? Yo los invito a revisar, en fin, el programa. Pueden revisar en los últimos años las conferencias que están en audio, en vídeo. Cuando se dejan los PowerPoints, pues están los PowerPoints, son más de 200 conferencias, y creo que hay un acervo ahí crecientemente histórico, que son su momento, no era la intención relevante, ¿no? Tenemos todavía en este semestre que ya va terminando, tenemos dos conferencias interesantes del doctor Martínez Rivera, sobre tendencias actuales de la urbanización en China, y después de la maestra Mariana Escalante sobre el nacionalismo chino y la propaganda popular desde Mao a la actualidad. Son las últimas dos conferencias, y yo insisto, lo haremos cada conferencia, los invitamos mucho a registrarse, participar también en la red académica de América Latina y el Caribe. Para los que trabajen en alguna institución o puedan llevarse alguno de los pósters donde no desaparezcan inmediatamente, ojalá que nos apoyaran y piensen seriamente en hacerse miembros de la red, y piensen seriamente también en hacer una en participar con una ponencia en la red. Yo les recuerdo, va a ser del 28 al 30 de mayo, ojo, del 2018. Entonces lo estamos haciendo con mucha antelación, y muy agradecidos de antemano de que le informaran, en fin, a colegas, estudiantes, funcionarios, empresarios, a gente en sus redes, ¿no? Yo les recuerdo, la conferencia de hoy va a ser en inglés, entonces we will switch now to English. And again, we are very, very happy to have with us Mr. Yang Nanhua from BAIC. I remind you, he's the general director of BAIC in Mexico. He has been working in BAIC for several years in Latin America, mainly in China, and he has also been working as a supervisor for sales at Yutong Bus during 2006-2010, so he has a long experience in the automobile and auto parts industry in China. Thank you very much. I simply remind you the dynamics of the presentations and conferences. This is a presentation of half an hour, 45 minutes, so that we have some time to start the discussion. So the floor is yours.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. Thanks to UNA for giving me such a great opportunity to do the presentation of BAIC. My name is Patrick Young. Patrick, it's easier for you guys to remember me. Thanks to the introduction of the professor, and thank you for coming. BAIC is, before we come to the point, I would like to share you my experience in Mexico, because this conference organized by the study on the relationship between Mexico and China. So I believe anyone who wants to know a foreign country have to experience enough. I know Mr. Professor has a lot of experience in China and know a lot of things. I came to Mexico in 2013, October. It was my first time. It was very embarrassing and funny. I visited León in the first week when I was suffering a lot from the jet lag. And my friend over there invited me to a very late dinner. It was 11 p.m. I was really tired and sleepy. But my hometown in China is Sichuan Province, where it's famous of spicy food. Of course, the spicy pepper came to China from Mexico in the 16th century. from then on, we start to plant spicy pepper and use it. So I think I'm enough used to the spicy food. When I came to the restaurant, I told to the waiter, please give me your most spicy pepper, I want to try. The waiter said, are you sure, sir? I said, yes, I do. 5 minutes, he brought me a small plate with the several slices of the green pepper. I forgot the name, sorry, but it's a green color. Be very careful, sir. Okay. I pick one slice and put it into my mouth. Oof, it was like a nuclear bomb exploded in my mind. And I ran out, holding on a tree, and cried for 20 minutes. This left me a very deep impression. And I think it's also a kind of hospitality of Mexican friends. But it's not over. When I came back to the table, I fell asleep on the seat for almost 1 hour. When I woke up, my local friend said, okay, now in front of you we have nine tequilas. Okay. And it means we have nine fondos. Nine fondos after a very spicy pepper. So, but it's very good. It's very good. So, from then on, I started to love this country. Then I came back to Mexico in 2014 in August. From then on, BIKE officially started the investigation and the marketing research. And we, after almost 1 year study, finally we chose one partner, which is Pikachu. We start to the exportation from beginning of 2016. Last year we launched BIKE brand in 2nd of June in Polanco. And so far we have brought more than 2,000 cars to Mexico. And meanwhile we were looking for an assembly plant. And now we have start our assembly job in Veracruz. And later in my presentation, I will give you more details. So, this is my introduction to myself, experience. Now we come to the main point. Okay. First, I want to talk something about globalization and localization. Most of Chinese companies in the past 20 or 30 years, because after we started the opening and the reforming policy from the state, from the federal level, we do a lot of exportations, and which, of course, it was quite a good business. So, gave a wrong direction of the Chinese companies, and I believe we are lack of globalization mind. And BIKE started the international business from 2013 after we purchased the technology from Swedish startup. And we believe if we go the same way of other Chinese automotive industry, we cannot be successful. That's why we do a little bit different way to others. And we have to do localization first instead of globalization. And that's why when I came to Mexico in 2014, I brought a Spanish boy who worked with me. And without the language problem, we can easily understand what the market requires or what our partner is thinking. And we have established BIKE Mexico, the local company. And we believe we have to be an economic citizen here, then goes to further social citizen. And I have only my team, several Chinese guys working here, but we have started the HR recruiting. And by end of this year, we're going to have around 10 or 15 Mexican employees. And we believe with the local team support, we can do much better job than our Chinese team. Now we come to the presentation to BIKE, which includes three parts, BIKE Group, BIKE National, and the BIKE Mexico. Sorry, I have to use this screen, so I cannot. talk to you. And the translation is in Spanish, so if I say something not clear, just refer to the words. Bike as one of the biggest Chinese automotive company, we have 59 years, this year 59 year, and with more than 110,000 employees. We have sales branch, and we have a joint venture with Mercedes and Hyundai. In last year, we were ranking 160 position of Fortune 500. This is the basic, very brief history of bike. You can see in 2002, we started collaboration with Hyundai. In 2005, started working with Mercedes. These two international automotive brands have a lot, bike to be a big company. And last year we have, this number come to 2015, but actually last year we already produced and sold more than 2.8 million kinds of vehicles with almost $550 billion revenue. We have several businesses. We have vehicles, components, services, new energy, and aviation. Later I explain what is the aviation business we have. This is a number I explained just now. In 2009, Bike acquired the Saab technology and know-how from Swedish government. GM. And from now we start our own brand. Before we mainly work with Mercedes-Benz and Hyundai for the Chinese market. But from 2009 we start Bike own brand. This is our headquarters and R&D center in Beijing. It looks like a terminal. Actually, it is very close to Beijing capital terminal. And so we call this Terminal 4 because we have three terminals in Beijing. We call ourselves building as Terminal 4. And we have several production bases all over around China. And we have another four production bases in other countries. bypass this. And also we have a lot of suppliers from software, hardware, and other components, even universities. And I hope from now we can establish relationship with UNAM for the study and other cooperation in Mexico. And okay, our vision by 2020, we were trying to have 5 million vehicle sales and to be the number third in China, and by 2025, try to be the top 10 in the world. Now is an introduction to Bike International. Bike International was established on 22nd of June 2013. We're coming to the fourth anniversary in next month. And we try to bring the best Chinese product to the global market. This guy is the chairman of Bike Group. And we have export to more than 45 countries. And we're going to have, now we have already three bases. You can see the Bike logo. We have one base, it is close to Vietnam. And one production base in Russia. One in South Africa. Actually, last year we invest $800 million in South Africa with the local, with the federal government of South Africa. And trying to, we're going to build 100,000 vehicle capability a year plant. And now we're going to have the fourth one in Mexico. And I think the final decision will be made by end of this year. And now we're looking for the right location for investment. I think according to the Mexican federal government, the basic investment will be $100 million or 50,000 productivity. And we also for the global markets, we have different and segmentations, and we try to use our financial arms to provide better service to our customers. And from this slide, you can see we have sorry, I made a mistake. This is not Russia. The production base is Iraq in the Middle East. So now we have four overseas production base. And this is our strategy, overseas strategy, 6-5-6. Six means the four production base plus India and Vietnam. So it's a six overseas production base. And five centers of market. Actually, it's based on the traditional Chinese export markets, mainly in Latin America, Southeast Asia, Africa, Middle East, and the former Soviet Union markets. And last number is 600,000 vehicles to export. Actually, it's not correct to only mention export, because we are going to localize the production in the overseas countries, and we will re-export from the production base in the four countries to the neighboring markets. This is just the achievements by Baikon National. After 3 years working, we have done more than 20,000 cars export, and with 45 countries and more than 100 partners in the different countries. So this is the branding. It's everywhere we go, we try to build our own, we call it the 4S, the dealerships. And we believe with a strong and unique image, we can bring better service to our customers. And I think some of you may have heard about the famous story of another Chinese automotive brand, which came to Mexico in 2008, but finally it was sold because they took a wrong path to Mexico. I cannot see much detail here, but we can discuss later. And so when bike came to Mexico in 2014, we believe we need to find the right partner and do our own branding. In service, we try to bring the best service to our customers. Now in Mexico, we offer five-year warranties, and we're trying to extend this guarantee period. Because our competitors from Korea are now offering 7 years, and of course, the competition is always good to the customers. And those photo wall come from the different pictures of our employees and partners who work in the different countries. And we have established our electronic network to manage the sales service and the internal of the internal transfer of information. So above is the basic introduction to Bike International, and now something about Bike Mexico. As I mentioned just now, we registered Bike Mexico last year in April, and we launched our brand on 2nd of June. And Bike Mexico is not only an office to manage the import and export, but it's a complete company to manage all of the business. Sorry. Of distribution service, finance, manufacture locally, and insurance. And we try to offer the whole value chain to our customers and partners. This is some history photos of Bike Mexico. We signed an agreement with Pikachu in 2015, and they visited us four times, and also several high delegations from that group visited Mexico in the past 2 years. And so far we have established 10 dealerships in the different cities of Mexico, from Chihuahua to Mexico City. And we are going to have another 20 dealers at least by end of this year. And this is the These are several models of our products. Of course, here is not advertising, so I will not see much details about our products. If you have interest, you are welcome to visit our dealership, which is in Benefico 3555. You just Google it and you can find it. And this is the car model of our product. And after the conference, I will need to professor, so you can see later. And we have did several activities in Mexico. This is a small car show in Guanajuato in 2015. These two are from the from the competition of the boat in Bahia de Bravo. This is car show of last year November in Mexico City. These two together. And we try to make some voice or noise or background in Mexican market and to make the customer know and understand who bike is and why we come here and how good we are. And then we're not going to take something from Mexico but to bring something to Mexico. First step of bike here is to register a company. So it means we are serious in this market and we're going to do long-term business and as well as some investment in this market, in this country. And we are very strong in electric or new energy vehicles. Actually, we only produce and market the electric cars. And this picture is the pollution of Mexico City. Actually, Beijing is even worse, or much worse than this. And that's why we are focusing or devoted our efforts to the electric cars. We believe this is a very good way to solve the problem of pollution. And we have studied the negotiation with the local governments, some union or organizations, try to bring the electric cars, or not only electric cars, but the whole solution to the country. Because Beijing is the biggest market of the electric vehicles, and as the biggest supplier, we have enough experience for the complete solutions. And we have already invested one spare part company in Elaprado. The name is Inafa. This is the Holland company. We merged this company in 2011. And in the same year, the factory of Inafa launched in Elaprado, which is producing the car roof window. So we do have a 5 year or 6 year experience in the manufacturing and production in Mexico. This is the aviation. Actually, we are the biggest shareholder of the best. I don't know how to say this. The small plane, which is the PT750, produced in New Zealand, and we bought this company, half share of this company in 2014, and now we try to bring this product to other countries. And the helicopter is the Italian product, also we are the shareholder. Talking about this one, PT750, because Mexico is the top 10 biggest tourist country, and every year you have a lot of visitors from different countries. I visit most of the cities of Mexico, I think even more than you guys, and I found it's a very good business or segmentation for the visitors to have skydiving from this plane. And actually we have some clubs here already in Mexico, and we try to provide finance arms to these companies or organizations to extend such business. I mean, we help the local company or Mexican people to make money from the tourists. This is one of our targets in Mexico. Besides business, also we do some social responsibilities. This is a photo we took last year in December. We went to the, sorry, I'm calling the city name. It's not far from Mexico City, just go 1 hour drive to the north. Sorry, my Spanish is bad, so I didn't remember his name. We donate 600 the bags to the to 6 schools. And I believe we will do more. Actually, we do 2 times. Once in this year, in March, but it's a small activity in Mexico City. And we are going to do more and take more responsibility of the as a social citizen. Thank you very much.
So please, if you can please give your name and where you come from.
Good morning, this is Ulises Diaz from Periódico Reforma.
Yeah.
You mentioned at the start of your presentation the number of vehicles that bike has sold here in Mexico. If you could expand a little bit on this. And also you mentioned about a plant that you have in Veracruz. Perhaps I didn't understand. Could you please also tell us when did you begin producing, how many cars are you producing, etc.
Okay, thank you very much. Actually, we...
Okay.
But I don't remember.
Yes.
Please.
Do
you want to make a question?
Yes.
Please.
My name is Edna Catra Xingua. My question is in Spanish, okay? Primeramente me gustaría que platicara un poquito más el tema de los vehículos ecológicos eléctricos, en este caso México, concretamente está interesado en disminuir la contaminación y ya se está aplicando los incentivos precisamente para apoyar este tipo de vehículos. En este sentido, Gayac, ¿cómo podría apoyar a los mexicanos, al gobierno, en este sector? Gracias.
Okay, first the numbers of the sales of bike in Mexico. We start sales from 2nd of June last year, and we brought, the first step we brought CBUs. When I say CBU, it means completed cars from China. And we have to pay the 20% custom duty, which is really a big pressure for us. And also, of course, we cannot charge to the customers, and we have to bear the loss of the profit. And we have brought, so far we have brought 1,600 CBUs, and also we have brought 500 SKD. SKD is a semi-knockdown, which means we brought components and spare parts to assembly in Veracruz. We have a partner, it's a Mexican company, 100% owned by private. We have a production line there. We already delivered 500 units of the components to them, and now they have started the assembly. So far we have finished 100 assembly, and the productivity is 10 units per day. Actually, with more labors, we can easily come over to 20 a day. So actually our target is to produce or assembly at least 5,000 a year in Veracruz. And for the retail sales, so far we have sold almost 500 cars to the end users. And since we have 10 dealers already, every month we can we have around 250 to 300 unit sales. So I hope I answer your first question. Your questions for the members and De La Cruz.
Since when are you producing in Veracruz? When did you start?
Last month,
okay.
April. For the second one, talking about the electric cars. Actually, we have talked to the different level of the government, from the federal. We talked with the Ministry of Economy, Ministry of Environment, and also the Ministry of Energy. Also, we talked with what's the name of electricity company? Second. Yeah, we talked with Second. Try to get some incentives, but it seems very difficult. Actually, in China, Chinese government gave a lot of subsidy to the electric cars, almost the half price of the electric cars. And also Chinese government are responsible to build the charging station, which requires a heavy investment. So we try to bring this solution to the government, but also we are going to use some financial arms from bike, because we are we have a company in Hong Kong which can easily get cheaper money, and we try to use the money to invest in Mexico to encourage the customers to use electric cars, because here in Mexico the rate of loan is pretty high, so any company or union or customer want to buy electric car, if he want to use financial arm, definitely the local rate is not workable. So we try to use foreign money to help them to change the car to electric ones.
Thank you very much. Questions?
Good morning. My name is Sergio Quiroz from Sechimex. We have two questions from Facebook from Ricardo Ramírez Motillo. Ricardo asked us if you think that San Luis Potosí is attractive to install the fabric, or in other way, if you can tell us where do you want to install the fabric in Mexico.
Okay, thank you. In fact, I have visited.
Sorry.
No problem.
I'm Pilar Juarez from Millennium Newspaper, and I want to know, you said that Bike is going to participate in the aircraft business, so I want to know which are the goals and which are the plan to participate in this sector.
You mean the aircraft?
The aircraft.
Okay.
Please.
Since we have the first question, we have visited many states in Mexico, and also we have the factory in Guanajuato. We haven't made the final decision where to invest, but we're going to invest somewhere who can give us better incentives, and also is easy to access to the components. Actually, we received two delegations from San Luis Potosí, and also we know the story about Ford. I mean, cancel the investment plan, and also three delegations from Nuevo León to bike, and several other delegations, and also I myself visit most of the industrial states here in Mexico. As I mentioned just now, we are going to make a decision by the end of this year. So now I cannot see which state is quite likely for us to invest. Mm-hmm. The second one is the aircraft. We're not going to compete any other competition to sell the airplane, but I think we're going to lease the airplanes to the skydiving companies for them to have a better service or a new place, better service, and to get more customers for them. This is our target. because I forgot to mention one thing just now in my presentation. Bike is not only a company who produce and sell vehicles. We're trying to bring the complete solution to the customers for transportation. Let's see, we are offering the new electric cars for the environment friendly ship, and also we have aircraft for people who can for the tourists which will enjoy the holiday, and also we work with the car rental companies to provide the better service of the to rent a car. So this is the we're working on several projects in Mexico, and I think very soon you will see the several segmentations we make some achievements.
Thank you, Mr. Yang, for the presentation. I have three questions. My name is Jose Manuel Vargas. I'm from the law school. I'm a professor there. The first one is about the timing. As you know, since Donald Trump take the presidency of the United States, we have a lot of uncertainty about the economics developments. And what do you think that you've come, I think, in a difficult time to Mexico, because nobody knows what's going to, mm-hmm. to happen with the NAFTA. So it seems to me that the Chinese enterprises, they are looking for a long time period. So what is your idea on that? The other thing is the automotive industry, it's too competitive now. We have a lot of brands here. So I was looking at the significance of the VAIC letters that they have in mm-hmm. the company. But what is the target of the idea? I'm sorry for the second question. Most of the Mexican importers bring a lot of things and products that they don't have the quality, because they are looking always for prices, low prices. So in the Mexican mind, most of the people in toys and everything, they think that the Chinese products are not good. And I think the foul company that do a joint investment with the Mexican company, because it was not a success, mm-hmm. you have to convince the Mexicans. So what are your strategies on that?
Yeah.
The theory is that you are thinking to push the Mexican government or the Chinese government to have a free trade agreement to take out the 20% on duties. Thank you, I'm sorry for the question.
Thank you. The second question.
One last question. How many employments are producing? It's not the story.
Yes, because we are.
How many employments is producing your enterprises in Mexico? You are talking about Guanajuato, Veracruz, Cancun.
Uh-huh. Okay.
How many employments?
Yes. First one is the timing. After the Mr. Twitter came to the position, and we believe or we regard it as a very good opportunity, because before the U.S. and Mexico, they are very closely tied to each other for in any aspects, and especially for the automotive industry, we have no good chance, I mean, for Chinese brands to come to Mexico. And after, since you are going to renegotiate the NAFTA agreement, or even the TPP has already cancelled by the new government of US, so we believe we have a better opportunity to in Mexican market. And as you mentioned, Chinese government and Mexican are discussing the free trade agreement, and As a company or enterprise, we hope this could be done very soon. But I don't know when and in and how much benefits we can enjoy from that. And the second one, talking about competition, yes, we understand because we have a lot of members before we came to the Mexican market, and we understand it's very, very, very tough, even much tougher than Chinese market. Even we have the biggest automotive market in China, Chinese market almost occupies 26% of the global auto markets. But but since we are an ambitious company and trying to be a top 10 by 2025, so we believe we must come to Mexico to test ourselves. And of course, we are quite confident with our technology and quality control because we purchased the all of the know-how from SAP, and also we have a joint venture with Mercedes-Benz in Beijing for the technology. Actually, this model was designed by this joint venture, R&D Center, with Mercedes-Benz. And in the past 15 years, with experience working with Mercedes-Benz and the Hyundai, we learned a lot. And since we have the biggest market of the world, I mean, the Chinese market is the biggest one in the world, and we can we have enough experience and test in such business. Actually, last month, during the Shanghai Auto Show, the global OEMs launched more than 137 new cars, new models, in Chinese market. So I think we have enough importance, and we have tested the production and quality in Chinese market first. Then we do export, or we bring the mature market products to Mexico. Of course, we also learn a lot from the field experience of FAW, and we try not to do the same thing, because as you mentioned, the market is very sensitive to the price. That's why we try to bring some other value-added services to the customers. We do the finance, we do insurance, we do the quick response of the after-sales service. So we can make money from other things, not only from the product. That's why we can do better service, better price than our competitors. And also we're lucky. The last thing I want to mention on this topic is we're the after FAW's failure, we are the first Chinese OEM to the Mexican market. So we can establish some standard for other Chinese competitors. I know there's another brand in launching their name in Mexico, but I think most of things they are following us. But actually, it's good. All of the Chinese OEMs try to bring better products, better service to Mexican market. Gradually, we can change or create a better image of the Chinese, I mean, maybe China, to the Mexican market. The third one is about the 20% of the custom duty. Actually, now since we have started assembly in Veracruz, so we have reduced the 20% of the completed cars to very small and very limited numbers, so we can, we are happy with this. So I hope I answered your question.
Thank you.
And talking about employees, in the company in Napa, in Ecuador, now we have already invested $30 million in this factory, and now we have around 400 employees. All of the jobs are done by local people. We have no Chinese guy, we have no foreign people there. And they are managed by the US headquarters in Detroit. And in the Veracruz, we have 50 laborers directly working for bike, because they also produce some other vehicles in that factory. And for Bike Mexico, the company here, now we're working with the HR companies trying to find around 10 to 15 local employees to work with me to manage our business here.
I have one question myself, if I might. So, if I understand correctly, today
or you are expecting to, there is a foreign direct investment law in Mexico that expects producers in automobiles to invest $100 million and to produce 50,000 units in 3 years. Mm-hmm. Is this what BAIC is expecting to do in 3 years or not? And the second question, investing in the automobile and truck sector by Chinese firms has not been easy in Mexico. No? There is the experience of FAO with Grupo Salinas, but also of FAO trucks in Pachuca, also of Foton in Veracruz, and it has not been easy. No? So what are the main experiences? How do you want to overcome the long time and costs for example, of FAO trucks that required like 5 or 6 years so that the production line started to work? What are your experiences on this?
Again, the investment. We are for the automotive industry, $100 million or 50,000 productives is not a big number. And since we're going to re-export from Mexico to other, first step is Latin American markets. So I guess actually last month the CEO of BAIC International mentioning the Mexican embassy, we had a conference there. We are going to invest at least 200 million euros to 500 million euros. Because 100 million is only enough for assembly factories. But if we want to have an industrial park, because we are going to bring our suppliers, so that number is not enough. And 50,000 is only workable for the local markets. If we want to re-export, I think we have to at least double the number, so 100,000, so which means at least the 200 million US dollar investment or 100,000 productivity. And talking about experience, yes, it's really hard for Chinese companies to go abroad to have a business or to have a factory in another another new market. And that's why we need localized our jobs here. We are working with the local HR companies, and once we started the investment of the bike plant, I believe we are going to hire the local company to work with us. And of course, a lot of state governments offer the incentives, which including the such activities or such support from them. We can do a lot of things. And in the future, and I think we're going to use the INAFA model to hire the local people to manage factories. And actually, the BAIC Mexico in the future is only a holding company with a very small team to manage the key issues. And most of the works, no matter sales, after sales service, opening more dealers, to provide finance service, insurance, and even the manufacturer, we're going to use the local employees. And I think this is a must, and we have to change the working style to export a lot of Chinese labor to other countries to do most of things. I think it's not workable from now.
Thank you, Mas. One last question. What about the difficulties to develop the business that you have in mind? I mean, about competitors, for example, we have some companies from the States, I think I've been here forever, and what about the federal government or other state-owned companies? What about the difficulties that you have to develop the business?
Yeah, I think the most difficult thing is to establish trust. And I mentioned I came back to Mexico in August of 2014. At that moment, nobody new bike and nobody knew Patrick. I have to knock to the door one by one. I think I visit most of the dealers in Mexico City. Here's my story. Every morning I stay in a hotel close to La Forma. Every morning I just took a taxi, just drive me 10 kilo, 20 kilo. Then I walk back to the hotel and knock to every dealers I can. I pass and talk to them. And also my problem is I don't know only myself. I couldn't speak Spanish. So most people I met, I cannot communicate with them. And I have to use the Google Translate. Translator. But the deal was working. Yes, finally we found a company and Pikachu who believe Chinese and China can make good products, and Chinese companies are willing to do right business in Mexico. And talking about government, also is hard for us to communicate at the very beginning. For example, we talk with the homologation office under the Ministry of Environment, because once we want to sell the products, we have to do the homologation first. And we call them, we send an email, but no answers. And finally, I have to wait for 3 days under the building to meet the right guy. But of course, finally, we accept back, and from then on, we do the jobs very easily. And now we have some names here, and we, no matter we talk to the government or unions or some companies, they can accept and can have a better idea exchange with us. So everything is very difficult at the very beginning. But once we overcome the problems, I think we will have a bright future.
Thank you.